Hey everybody, my name is Adam Wysor and I am a territory manager for the Fluke Corporation, and today I'm here at Test Equipment Depot and I'm here to talk about the Fluke SMFT-1000 solar multifunction tester. So what we have here today is the SMFT-1000. This is a complete photovoltaic commissioning and O&M solution for safety testing, performance testing, for a photovoltaic system. Plus, we also offer a dedicated software solution that allows you to take the measurements from the tool and integrate it into reporting software. What this tool can do is it integrates the solar workflows for O&M testing from your initial measurements all the way to final reporting. And it conforms to the IEC standard, the IEC 62446-1 testing standard for solar systems. Okay, so I wanted to talk a little bit about what's included in the SMFT-1000 kit. So you get the SMFT-1000 tester, and first and foremost, we have a new version, a second generation version of our irradiance meter. The difference between the one that we previously came out with and this one is that this one's Bluetooth, so it will actually wirelessly transmit the data from the irradiance meter out to the tester. What's really important about irradiance data is that it's a crucial piece for accurately getting that IV curve trace. So you have to have the irradiance meter, which is included in the kit. We also include a reel for doing testing, as well as voltage test leads, a current clamp, as well as a full set of MC4 connectors, which allows you to connect the device to different areas, combiner box, inverter. You'll notice on the tester itself, we have an integrated color screen. This allows you to actually display the IV curve live. So as you're adding measurements to the tester, this will display the IV curve on the tool itself and compare it to the model specs. So any manufacturer specs that you happen to have, you can trace that back to what would be the normal curve for based on the manufacturer specs. And finally, as I mentioned earlier, we can take all this data and report it directly to our TruTest software that allows you to do analysis and reporting. So, next thing we're going to do is we're going to talk about some of the functionality, some of the individual tests that you can do with the SMFT-1000. Okay, so now we want to do a quick run through of some of the individual functions of the SMFT-1000. So first we're going to start here with a visual inspection. So what this does is this is a quick checklist for a technician to do a series of visual inspections. The nice thing about this is that you can go paperless, is you can actually check that each one of these tasks was completed, enter it into the tool, and then transfer that data to the reporting software. Next up is the protective conductor resistance. So this is the basically earth grounding and bonding test, lightning protection, as well as being able to do quick point-to-point measurements using your remote probe. Next up is the polarity check. So simply this is a pass-fail test that allows you to just make sure that the positive and the negative wires are correctly connected to the combiner box or the inverter or the switch gear. And next up we have the open circuit voltage as well as the short circuit current test. So the open circuit voltage test checks that the module strings are correctly wired and that the expected number of modules are present in the series with the string. The circuit current test or the short circuit current test just verifies that you've got the correct operational characteristics of the system and that no major faults are present there. Next up, we have our power functionality. So what this does is this is an AC and DC functionality test. So what this allows you to do is just test the power output from the system to make sure that the DC power coming out of the modules is inverted properly to AC power as required by the IEC standard. Next up, we have an insulation resistance test. So this allows you to test the insulation between the ground and the PV system, as well as any two measurement points in the PV system. It just helps you troubleshoot any insulation faults that might be present in any of the wires or the cabling to ensure that the system's operating properly. Next up, we have the IV curve trace. So like we were talking about before, doing an IV curve trace, it's important to have the irradiance meter with you to get the output of the panel. Enter that information into the tester. So this is a graphical representation of the voltage applied across the device compared to or alongside the current flowing through it. Hence you get the IV curve. So this will actually give you a nice, quick, and effective test, and you can test it up against a known standard. So for each manufacturer, they may have different limits, different standards, so you're able to actually enter in nominal measurements and then do a comparative test against the manufacturer's specs. Next up, we have a diode test. So the diode test actually allows you to do a couple of different things. There's a bypass diode, and then there is a blocking diode. The diodes prevent current from flowing from good cells into bad cells that might be underperforming. They also make sure that current is flowing in the proper direction. So this allows you to run a couple of those different tests just to make sure that you're not doing any kind of a damage to the system. Finally, I wanted to talk a little bit about the auto testing function. This is a really nice feature of the SMFT-1000 because you can connect your test leads, go to an auto test, and what we've done is we've added 8 different automatic testing setups based on different combinations of what you may want to test for. So you could either elect to do a test that is with or without an insulation test. You could do it based on different categories, or you can also do it based on different protection classes. Whatever requirements you may have for your specific system, the auto test is a really nice function because it's a big time saver for you. Currently, we have 2 different versions of this kit. So the SMFT-1000 comes with a remote test probe, test leads, a 30 meter reel, the Bluetooth version of the irradiance meter, obviously the tester itself, a current clamp, and a backpack. The second version of the kit, the SMFT-1000 kit, the only difference there is that it actually includes the MC4 connectors, as well as the TruTest software for doing the analysis and reporting. But other than that, the two kits are identical except for the MC4 connectors and the software is included. Just a quick note on the backpack too, because a lot of solar systems are on rooftops or in remote locations, technicians are out in the field or they're climbing up and down ladders and stairs. Everything fits nicely in the backpack, so it's a nice way to keep all your tools in one simple location and makes the whole kit highly portable. So if you have any other questions or for more information, feel free to visit testequipmentdepot.com. Again, I'm Adam Wysor with Fluke. Thank you for watching.